Ladies and gentlemen, give a big Salt Lake City welcome to Bobbie Gee.
Do what you do so well that when you do it, people want to see you do it again. And when they do, they will go out and tell others. Ladies and gentlemen, I learned that from Walter Elias Disney. Actually, he was dead when I came to the company, but they had sayings all over walls, all over the place, things that he had said, and that was one of the most important things he ever taught his employees. And the reason was, if we all went out there and did what we did so well that people wanted to see us do it again, you know what that is? It's called referrals, referrals, referrals. It's called you don't have to work so hard to make a living. You don't have to work so hard at what you do because your customers are out there doing advertising for you. And my objective tonight is to turn you all from a the to a my. Now, what do you do for a living? You sell furniture. Now, he can either be the furniture salesman, or he can be my furniture supplier. Let me tell you how I figured this out. I received a phone call one night from one of my daughters, my oldest daughter, and she was very excited. She was very excited. And I said, honey, what's going on? And she said, Mom, I'm having a ball. I said, doing what? She said, we're out shopping for our very first home. And during the conversation, as we were talking about this, she happened to say one line that just hit me right smack between the ears here, and it was this, Mom, my real estate lady is so nice. And I leaned back against the kitchen counter, and I thought about that statement for a long time. And so I started making a habit of really listening to the way people talked about people they dealt with. And so one weekend, it was in July, and all three couples of us were all married in July. And so there were three couples, and we always did one of those Four Seasons trips, you know, every July. So we took off one July for Santa Barbara, California, and our husbands got their golfing gear on, and us ladies put on swimsuits and went down by the swimming pool. Now, I want to share with you that we were three of the most boring women at that hotel on that given day. Because as we laid down in our chaise lounges around that swimming pool, I happened to notice everybody's reading material. I had taken In Search of Excellence. One of my friends had How to Save Money on Your Income Tax. The other one had something about computer software. And as I looked at our reading material, I said, you guys, we are boring. We are really boring. So we laid down our reading material and started talking what is commonly known, as you men all know, as woman talk. Now, when women start talking woman talk, very often the topic of jewelry comes up, which it did. And my friend Pat turned to my friend Kay, and she said, Kay, you just have to try my jeweler. And I thought to myself, there's that great big word again, my jeweler. And I started listening to other people, and they would say, my furniture store can help you out. My insurance person, I know they could handle that. My travel agent. And then I would hear other people talking about the video store that they traded with, or the market, or the service station. And I began to start thinking, what is the difference between a the and a my? And when somebody becomes a my, do they make more money? You bet they do. Because when people start referring to you in words of ownership, that means they are locked into you. That means you are not up for grabs. You are a customer that is loyal to that person. Now, if they refer to you as the real estate person or the insurance person or whatever it is you, the car salesperson, whatever it is you do, that means that customer is up for grabs and anybody can take them away. So what is it you have to know? What's the difference between the does and the mys? Well, the does give customer service. How many of you out there that deal with, well, most of you have to sell something, even if you're selling yourself, we have to sell something out there. How many of you deal with other people that you have to sell something to? May I see your hands, please? Okay, practically the whole crowd. How many of you give what you would consider to be very good customer service? Let me see your hands. Very interesting. Practically the whole room. But how many people, if I went to your customers and I start talking to them, we would refer to you as a the or a my? You see, the does can give very good customer service. But it's only when you transfer over to the my, I know, then you have the hook.